An Evening with Bruni, a night to celebrate all that's great and good about the Celtic captain, and for fans to get some insight into what makes him tick. Captain Invincible, So we're outside the SEC Armadillo on the banks of the Clyde, looking splendid in the colours of green. Scott Brown is on his way just shortly, as are so many hundreds of Celtic fans and VIPs as well. We'll be speaking to them just before the event gets underway.
Looking forward to tonight, Scott?
Should be entertaining. Hopefully I am anyway. Yes, he will always be one of the
greats. TV's Martin Compston, the man who narrated the Bruni DVD and is a huge Hoops supporter. He couldn't wait to pay tribute to Bruni tonight and said it was a privilege to voice his DVD.
It was an honour. I've been lucky enough to know Scott a few of the years, and he's a top boy, but as it says on the DVD, he's a genuine icon of our times. You know, he's the greatest. I mean, Comics Day was my hero growing up, but in terms of modern day captains, they don't come better than Scott. He's just in terms of what he's won, how he's done it, made history, treble champions, invincible champions, all of that, and also he likes Scooter, and I don't mind about Scooter, so he's a top boy.
Around 3,000 Celtic supporters packed out the Armadillo in total, all eager to see and hear from their captain. But two men who are already quite familiar with him are golfer Stephen Gallagher and first former teammate and fellow captain Stephen McManus.
Yeah, this is a great opportunity for everybody to kind of get to know Scott, to see what he's really like behind the kind of game face as such. So it's a great occasion for him, for his family, and it's something that everybody can be proud of.
And you yourself, you're looking forward to hearing some of the stories that you know all too well?
It'll probably bring back a lot of good memories. Like I say, when I got approached to come and speak, it was something you'd never turn down, just to show your appreciation and your respect for Scott. I've known Scott a long time, and he's been a fantastic servant for our club, and long may it continue.
Stephen Gallagher, so you've got quite close with Scott off the pitch. How is his golf game these days?
It's erratic. Not like his consistent performances are now on the park. He doesn't get enough time to play, obviously, but he loves the game, and it's great for me. We get to have a hit every now and then.
And looking forward to tonight, I suppose you already know a lot about him, but there might be a few things that you don't know that will come up tonight.
Yeah, I'm really looking forward to it, to be honest. There is a lot I don't know about him, but I know him pretty well, and he's a top lad, so hopefully there's a few laughs en route today.
Paul, you're the voice of Celtic TV, and tonight you're on stage with the captain. You looking forward to it?
I certainly am, Ryan. I have to be honest, it's countdown to the big kickoff, and the nerves are jangling, but you know, I'm just looking forward to getting out. You can hear the buzz of the crowd taking their seats, and I'm just looking forward to an evening with Bruni. I think for both of us it's a new experience, actually sitting down in a kind of chat show format and sitting there with 3,000 people looking on. It's not intimidating at all.
Scott, mic'd up and ready to go. You're looking forward to telling some stories tonight?
Yeah, definitely. It's something different. I've not spoken in front of 3,000 people. It's different running about in front of 60,000 and not having any thoughts about the crowd and stuff there at the time. But when you're sitting on the stage and nobody's saying a word, and I'm looking out and I can see them all, it's something totally different and a little bit more nerve-wracking.
He's won 19 trophies, 17 as our captain. He's led us to, so far, 8 in a row. He's captained us to the treble. And over and above all that, he's given us one of the most memorable and iconic goal celebrations in our history. So it's a real honour and a privilege to be here and to ask you now to give the warmest and the loudest of Celtic welcomes to our captain, our leader, and the legend that is Scott Brown. You know, that first season that you were at the club, it was obviously a challenge as a footballer, but you know, personally, obviously, you know, at the club, Tommy wasn't well, but then you obviously had, you know, your own personal issues with your sister not being as well. But how difficult was that for you at that time?
Yeah, it was a hard time, and the 3 years were very close together, huge family holidays and stuff like that. But Tony and Fiona going through the same situation, and it was the day Tommy died, my wee sister got flowers to the house, and it was like the saddest thing that has ever happened to me. Knowing my sister's not well, Tommy's still thinking about like other people instead of thinking about himself, and it shows you the character of the man, and it shows you what a legend he's always going to be. And but yeah, in the first season, it was extremely hard.
The first game, if I remember rightly, at Rugby Park, the first time that you were made captain.
Yeah, it was one of those weird ones. He went around the dressing room and went, "Oh no, I can't get to anybody else. I'll get to Bruni." So I obviously knew Tony from Hibs, and at the time, probably wasn't a captain in the making. I was kind of young, naive, kind of just enjoying life. And yeah, I come on the park for Lee Naylor. So Tony goes, "Oh, you're coming on for Nails. We're getting beat 1-0. Go on and take the armband for Louisville." I was like, "Oh yeah, no problem." I went, "Gaffer, where are we going on?" And he was like, "You're going on left back, wee man." I don't know if he could remember me for Hibs.
Ladies and gentlemen, our manager, Neil Lennon.
And we're all so glad there's only one.
he's an outstanding player over the years. He's in outstanding form at the minute. And he knows what his body's all about now. He covers the ground still really well. His performance in Lazio away was unbelievable. His performance at Ibrox was unbelievable. So it's sometimes in the games where we're dominating and scoring lots of goals, you know, Brownie's role gets sort of undervalued. But in the real pivotal games when it's very tactical and you have to think your way through it, you know, believe it or not, Brownie does think his way through things at times, like, you know what I mean? He's very good now at reading the game. He's evolved his game from being this real dynamic box-to-box midfielder, where now he's one of the best holding midfield players in Britain, where he sees the game, recycles the ball, covers the gaps. But more than anything, he leads, you know, and he has the utmost respect of everyone in that dressing room. That is the key. You know, and he's the utmost respect of the coaching staff as well. And he's earned it. He's really earned it.
Can you please give up for Stephen McManus?
It's been great, certainly for somebody like myself, how you can see his development over the years. And when you're coaching our young players every day, there's no greater inspiration than for them to look at the way Scott leads his life.
So we're going to go full Graham Norton here and fill up the couches with our last two guests of the night. Broadcaster and presenter Peter Martin and the BAFTA award-winning actor Martin Compston. We've obviously been a star of the big screen, the small screen. We know you, so many people know you here from Line of Duty, but in terms of the roles that you've had, where does voicing the Bruni DVD stand in your career?
You know what, it was an honour because I've got lucky to know the guys, but you know, Mick and Lenny and Scott, they're my genuine heroes.
One of the things that you won't be aware of, and he never mentions it to anybody, he might be a leader on the field, but off the field, this man knows what it's like to represent Celtic for people who are sick, for kids who look at him and idolise him. He's always got time for them. He is... He is, for me, an absolute credit. And the best thing I can say about Scott Brown is, if you think he's a good player, he's an even better person.
Scott, again, I always think of that great Jock Stein quote when he spoke to the Celtic fans back in the 50s as a player and said maybe that while Celtic wasn't maybe his first love, but it would be his longest and his enduring love. And I always think of you in that case. And is that the case that you've came here, you are, as Neil said, one of us, and it's a club you love and a support that you love?
When I first came, everyone knew that I didn't know too much about Celtic, but over the years, I've grew to love it, and it's a place that I can call home, and every single one of you is in my family, and that's what this club's all about. Scott Brown.